guys, what's up? I'm Nikhil, your DeepPad instructor, and in this Cinema 4D tutorial, I'm going to show you guys how to create this really cool looking 3D sci-fi mech in Cinema 4D, which looks kind of like a Star Force 3D spaceship, and it's pretty interesting and really simple to create. So without any further ado, let's get started. Alright, so before we get into Cinema 4D, we need to create a really nice displacement map for our material. And to create a really complex and really nice looking displacement map, I'll be using this free app called JDisplacement, which is pretty nice to create really complex looking displacement. So it's pretty simple and easy to use. What I need to do is, let's go and select one design that we like. Let's hit R, which is the hotkey to generate a map. And then I can, you know, create different kind of designs by just, you know, clicking on this icon. If I don't want a specific look, I can just click on this one, which is gonna turn it off. And I'm gonna turn this and this off as well, so you can see what's going on. So now you can see we get a really nice and simple look, and this is what I'm going for. So I'm gonna hit save just like that, and I'm gonna save it, or maybe I'll just override this one. And one more, I'm gonna create one more displacement. So I'm gonna go with this design. Hit R to generate it. Now you can play around with different number of settings or changes that you can do. So I can play around with the background iteration. So I can bring this down just like so. Also, I'm gonna bring down the background brightness a bit. And for the iteration, I'm gonna increase this just to increase the complexity of the map. So yep, I think this is a pretty good look to go with. So I'm gonna hit save just like that, and let's save this up. There we go. And that is all we need to do to generate some really nice displacement. Now we have different designs as well. You can go and choose from to create a different kind of look, depends on your personal preference. So I'm gonna close this up, and here we are in Cinema 4D. Now I'm using the Cinema 4D R19 version, but you can use, of course, any version higher than Cinema 4D R14. And also we will be needing Octane Render to create a really nice displacement. You can create displacement maps without Octane Render as well, but it will be very, very heavy on the system. So to keep things moving faster, I'm going to be using Octane for this. So right off the bat, let's create a sphere just like so. And as you can see, we have pretty low number of segments in the sphere. So I'm going to increase it. So let's click on the sphere and increase the segments to around 64. Just like that, so we get a really nice displacement. And let's go ahead and add an HDRI to get a really nice lighting and understanding for our complete scene. So let's go into object and click on HDRI environment. So right over here, I'm gonna click on this icon. Let's click on this black space and go into this and locate the HDRI. You can of course use any kind of HDRI that you have. You can also download free HDRIs from Google as well. So in this case, I'm gonna go with this one, which is pretty interesting one. So I'm gonna hit open, set this to no, and there we have it. So as you can see, we get this really nice look. Now it's pretty, you know, kind of hard, difficult to understand right now. So what I'm gonna do is pretty quickly, let's create a material that is an Octane material. So I'm gonna click on create shader, Octane and Octane material. Let's double click to open this up, and let's go into the material type, and I'm gonna set this to glossy from diffuse because we need a really nice and shiny material. So if I just drag and drop it onto the sphere, right at the bat you can see we get this really nice reflection backlight for our object. So pretty cool. Let's go into the displacement map and add a displacement that we just created. So what I'm gonna do is, in the texture, I'm gonna go ahead into Octane and add a image texture. All right, let's go into add displacement. And in the texture, I'm gonna locate the texture that we created. So I'm gonna use this one that we have. And let's hit open, no. And as you can see, the displacement is loaded up. But the issue with this is, as you can see, our texture is not looking that nice. It's kind of getting messed up because we need to increase the resolution. So what I'm going to do is, let's go into level of detail and let's set this to all the way up to 8K resolution. So it's going to take a few seconds, and now you can see we have this really nice high detail displacement, which looks pretty nice. And as you saw, it is really simple and easy. So now what I can do is I can play around with the amount of the displacement. So I can go really high. Now, more amount that you're going to put in, the more heavy the scene is going to get. So I'm going to set this to somewhere around 35, which according to me looks pretty nice and decent. As you can see, you can go pretty intense as well. Like, just to show you guys, if I go do something like maybe 80, you can see we get this really cool look, but at the same time it's pretty heavy as well. But it's a really nice, you know, technique to play around and create some really complex looking objects. So I'm gonna go with 35, which to me looks pretty good. I can again later on change it as well. So that's that, and it's pretty simple to do. So now let's go ahead and make our material really nice and complex. So what I'm gonna do is, let's pretty quickly create an object and octane camera. Let's turn this on and let's go into octane camera and set the focal length to 28 millimeters. Let's close this up for the moment, and pretty quickly I'm gonna just, you know, set up the camera pretty quick. Maybe somewhere around there. Okay, let's come out of the camera. Okay, let's zoom in a bit so we can see the changes taking place in the texture. So let's double click to open this up. And then what I'm gonna do is, let's add a bump map. So let's go into texture, octane and image texture. Go ahead and add a really nice bump map. I'll be using this bump maps from Zomax, which is free again. So I'll provide the link in the description or in the project file, so you can go and download it. So I'm gonna use this one and hit open, click no. And it's gonna take few seconds depending on your system. And as you can see, we get this really complex looking bump map, but it's not looking that good at the moment. So what I want is to have a really nice and kind of a rusty look in some section of our mech. So to achieve that, what we can do is, so let's go into the bump map and go into octane, and let's add a gradient. Let's go into the gradient, and I'm gonna bring this close just like so. So now you can see we have our bump in only few sections of our mech, and that is what I'm going for. So I'm gonna actually make it a bit gray, just like so, you can see it more properly. And you can also go into the bump map, and again I'm gonna bring down the power. Let's bring it up to maybe 2. Let's see how it looks. I think it's a bit too much, so I'll go with something like 1.3 or something, which I think it's a pretty nice number to go with. Okay, this is what I'm gonna go with. And you can increase, you can play around with the wraparound border as well, so I can set it to different look if I want to achieve that. But I think this is looking pretty good. Maybe I'll increase the gamma and let's see what we have. Okay, maybe I'll bring this down to 2 actually. Yep, looking pretty good. As you can see, we have the bump in just few, you know, random section of our mech. So it's gonna make our mech look, you know, kind of a rusty and realistic, I'll say. So let's go into the index, and I'm gonna increase the index to around 4 because I want to make it really nice and glossy. Now you can see we get this really nice reflection. So yep, that is what I'm going for. Let's go back into the camera view and let's see what we have. So as you can see, this is looking very nice. So let's pretty quickly add some lights to this, but before that I'm gonna bring down the opacity of the, or the power of the HDRI to low, to maybe something like 0.7 or something. Something like that looks good to me. And then what we can do is, let's go ahead into object and add an octane area light and bring this right over here just like so. Let's go into the light. Let's go into visibility and camera visibility. I'm gonna turn this off. Let's go into light settings, and I'm gonna play around with the power depending on what kind of look I'm gonna go with. So I'm gonna keep it somewhere around there maybe. And also I'm gonna check this box which says use light color. Let's go into octane light. I'm gonna make this red just like so. For the shadows, I can set this to map soft shadows, and let's go into octane light again. You can play around with different number of settings, but mainly we need to just play around with the power to get the desired look. So I'm gonna keep it somewhere around maybe that to get an intense look, but I think that's a bit too much, so I'm gonna go with something like that. And for the position, I'm gonna bring this just a bit, just like so. So I think this is looking pretty good at the moment. So let's go back into material actually, and I think I'm gonna add some roughness to this. So let's go ahead and add a little bit of roughness, not much, maybe a bit more. Okay, something like that looks good to me. Let's close this up and let's go back into the bump. Actually, I'm going to increase the bump a little bit to maybe 1.5 or something. Bring it about 0.5. Let's see. Nope, this is not what I'm going for. Let's set this to maybe something like 3. Okay, pretty cool, looking really nice. Let's go into the roughness and I'm gonna bring this down a bit, just like so. Okay, pretty cool. Let's come out of the camera pretty quick and let's set up our lights. So as you can see, one we have at the right. So I'm gonna just hold control and drag this to create a duplicate and rotate this 180 degrees. And let's change the color of this light to kind of a really nice blue color. Something like that, which I think is looking pretty good. Let's go back into the camera to see the actual look. Yep, I think this is looking pretty good. I'm gonna make it a bit darker, I think, the light. So let's make it a bit darkish blue. Just like so. Yep, pretty happy with this. We can also rotate the sphere depending on if you want to get a different, you know, look, a different side of the mech. Yep, I think this is looking pretty good. Now what I'm going to do is let's go ahead and add a cylinder, a tube to this, not a cylinder. And I'm going to play around with the shape just like so. Also come out of the camera. You see we have it. And let's play around with the outer radius. I'm gonna set this to somewhere around there. And for the inner radius, I'm gonna increase this just like so. Also, I'm gonna increase the number of segments. So let's increase the height segments a bit and the cap segments. I'm gonna set the cap segments to 1 actually. And let's increase the rotation segments to 64. And if I add this, and what I'm gonna do is let's hold control and duplicate this material. So now we have the second one. So let's pretty quickly, I'm just gonna rename this to 02 and this one to 01. So we don't get messed up. And let's drag this material onto this one. And as you can see right off the bat, we get a really crazy look. And I think it's a bit too much. So what I'm gonna do is let's double click to open the material. And let's go into displacement. Let's bring down the displacement to around 20. All right. And let's go ahead and change the texture for our displacement to the second texture that we had. That is this one. And let's hit open. No. And it's going to take a few seconds. And there we have it. And I think it's a bit too much. So let's go back into displacement. And let's go with a really low number, like maybe 15 or something. And yep, this is actually starting to look pretty cool. Maybe 5. Okay, this is looking pretty nice. 5, I think 5 is good to go with. So let's close this up. You can also play around with the tube again. So I'm gonna increase the outer radius a little bit and the inner radius a bit as well, just like so. Maybe something like that. Or maybe I'll just, you know, make it something like so. Yep, I think this is pretty nice. Let's go into the camera and I'm gonna actually move this a bit to the top. Something like that. Okay, so as you can see, this is looking very nice. Let's go into the Octane Sky and I'm gonna bring down the power a little bit. So now you can see we get this really nice look. Yeah, pretty happy with this. And the really cool thing about creating this kind of material is you can use any object and you can add this material on that object and use it. So it makes things pretty simple. So I can also maybe let's add something interesting. So I'm gonna use maybe a torus or something. All right, and let's bring down the radius just like so. Also the size of the radius just like that. And let's move it a bit up. And let's come out of the camera for the moment. And if I, you know, just zoom in a little bit, Also, I'm going to increase the segments to get a smoother look for our displacement, which is very important. And if I drag and drop it, the displacement onto this, bam, there we have a really cool looking kind of a spaceship effect. It's not a spaceship effect, but a spaceship look, 3D look. And just imagine creating this kind of modules manually. It's going to take a very, very long time to add so much of detail into our model. And I think the bump is not, you know, it's going to give us a bit of jittering when we render. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the bump. And let's go right over here and bring down the power to 1. And also bring up the gamma to 3. I want to bring down the gamma to 1 as well, just like so. So we get a really nice and simple look for this. Maybe, oh, not 0.1, 1. Okay, and for this one as well. So let's go into bump, bring this down to 1, and this one to 1 as well. Okay, so this looks pretty cool. Again, I can go into this material and let's play around with the displacement a bit. So I'm going to increase this 10, and as you can see, this is a really cool looking spaceship that you can use it. So I think I'm going to delete the tube actually and use the torus instead of a tube, because that looks much interesting. Maybe increase the radius a bit. Something like this, looking pretty nice. As you can see. And the benefit of using Octane is it's pretty fast. It's gonna use the complete GPUs that we have. So it's a GPU based renderer. So yep, it's gonna be pretty fast. And I think this is looking pretty nice. You can of course use your light setup or different HDRI to get a different look. Depends on your personal preference. And again, you can use different kind of displacement map as well to get a different look each and every time. Again, if I go into torus and let's set the UV mapping to something like maybe cylinder, you're gonna get a different look, as you can see. If I set this to maybe a sphere, you're gonna get a different look. If I set this to a cubic, you're gonna get a different look. Now, cubic is one of the more detailed ones, so it's gonna be really intense. So I normally prefer setting it to UV mapping as well, UV mapping, because I think it's pretty nice and decent and looks pretty interesting. Also, you can again go into torus and increase the segments, the pipe segments. I'm gonna set this to 64. So the, you know, the complete look is more smoother and we don't get any anti-aliasing issues. So as you can see right off the bat, we have a really nice looking 3D mech, which looks kind of a Star Wars scene. And you can make it look more and more complex depending on what kind of look you want to go with. You can go and increase the displacement to get a really intense look. So if I go into the displacement again, and let's play around with something like 100. So you can see you get some more intense displacement, which looks interesting depending on your personal preference again. So yep, that is all for today guys. I hope this video was helpful, and I will see you guys in my next video. Till then, take care. Thank you so much for watching guys.